बाबा आदम के जमाने की एकमात्र निशानी, समझ रे बाबा समझ। दुनिया कितनी आगे निकल गई है और तू अभी भी भजन की दुनिया में। देख असल जिंदगी में ना बहुत झोलझाल होता है, पर ये वर्चुअल वर्ल्ड की दुनिया कितनी क्लीन और सिंपल है। नो फिजिकल वायलेंस, नो टेंशन ऑफ सोशल विजिट्स, नो खर्चा ऑन फ्रेंड्स, ओनली बातें, वीडियोस, कमेंट्स, लाइक इट और अब्यूज इट, और बहुत सारी खूबसूरत यादें।
तुम गलती कर रहे हो, क्यों नहीं समझते हमारा समाज इन सबसे ऊपर है। हम मिलकर बातें करते हैं, ना कि इन साइट्स पे किसी को ऐसे कमेंट्स दे जिससे सिर्फ दुख और मायूसी हो। जब तक हम लोगों से जुड़ेंगे नहीं, हकीकत हमसे कोसों दूर रहेगी। यही हमारी संस्कृति है और इसीलिए सारी दुनिया भारतीय युवा सोच को आश्चर्यचकित होकर सदियों से देखती आई है। सो प्लीज वर्चुअल वर्ल्ड एंड वेस्टर्न कल्चर विद प्राइवेसी सेटिंग्स को अपना गुलाम मत बनाओ। सदियों रहे हम गुलामी की जंजीरों में, हमें ये समझना होगा कि जिंदगी की मुश्किलें और खुशियां जैसे हमारे पेरेंट्स ने इन साइट से जुड़कर पूरी नहीं की थी। और मैंने भी यही सीखा है, तुम्हारे और तुम्हारे दोस्तों की तरह नहीं, मुबारक या अफसोस के दो शब्द कह दिए बस, ना मिलना ना जुलना। मैं हर त्योहार के दिन मम्मी के साथ मिठाई बनाती हूँ और उन्हें पड़ोसियों में बांटती हूँ।
बड़ी बड़ी बातें वड़ा पाव खाते।
तुम्हारी तरह नहीं, इमेज अपलोड कर दी और दावत दे दी। मैंने यहाँ तक सुना है दोस्तों कि अक्सर दोस्तों के दोस्त दोस्त बनकर दुश्मन बन जाते हैं, ये कैसा धोखा।
आता माजी सटक ली, सेटिंग्स में जा, सेटिंग कंट्रोल कर दे।
नहीं कर,
हो गया क्या रे तू, फिर को समझाना मतलब चार तलक पैदल जाना। कर जैसा करना है वैसा कर। देखो दोस्तों, ये मेरा एकमात्र फ्रेंड जिसने मुझे पहले ही अनफ्रेंड कर दिया।
हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माय नेम इज नेहा बरी फ्रॉम 12D AJC मुंबई। आप सबको हम सब की ओर से हार्दिक शुभेच्छा। ही इज माय फ्रेंड हर्षल पाटिल, शी इज माय फ्रेंड नवमी कोंडे, बोथ फ्रॉम 12D AJC मुंबई। A mild argument, but let me ask you seriously, was it worth? What is their argument? Okay, Harshal. Okay, bye. Thank you.
Bye. Bella, how are you there?
With the advent of science and technology, our lives have changed so much. It is now easier to connect with each other. Thanks to the idea that is social networking, blogging, sharing of photos, videos and instant messaging. And to add on to the fun, there is Game World, World of Warcraft, thanks to Blizzard Entertainment. Similarly, is it not now time to thank Zuckerberg, Hurley, Javed, Benjamin for giving us such wonderful sites like Facebook, Twitter, YouTube and Dailymotion. Not to forget the WhatsApp duo, Bran Acton and Jan Koum. Yes, it is. We salute their idea of giving us such sites like Facebook, Twitter and much more. But these must be useful in sharing of right information to our preferred audiences and to raise our opinions in magnitude as well as direction to reduce conflicts. Am I right? Now, let us go deep into the topic and discuss it. Social networking and informative sites, how far they have educated and updated us. Social networking, how good, how bad?
Hey Neha, kai to much, ho gaya tera? De, tera number de. Mast joke aur cartoon bhejta hu, pappu ka. Tujhe sab hai pata, meri maa. Ye WhatsApp hi hai, meri jaan.
That's enough, Harshal. कैसी नियमत दी है ऊपर वाले ने जिंदगी की सूरत में, क्या हमने अपना जहां बना लिया बस व्हाट्सएप और ट्विटर में। मूविंग ऑन फर्दर, आफ्टर मोबाइल्स एंड विद मोबाइल्स, सोशल नेटवर्किंग इज द हॉटेस्ट टॉपिक ऑफ टीन टाउन। दिस डिस्कशन वुड बी यूजफुल फॉर सेकेंडरी एंड सीनियर सेकेंडरी स्टूडेंट्स। देर आर टू थिंग्स कॉमन विद अस, आवर लव फॉर दीज साइट्स एंड दैट वी आर टीनएजर्स। You can connect with us by sending your feedback at acsmuma@yahoo.co.in. Now let me introduce to some more friends. Piyush,
Jinu Abraham, Devika Kadam, Ritu, and Angel, all from AJC.
Thanks, Neha, for giving such a cold introduction of AJC students who always rock. Anyway, you seem to be a moderate personality who does not like too much of social networking but still do it. Everybody knows, media and friends told us so. Now it is time to grow up in new networks like WhatsApp and Instagram. Facebook alone has more than a billion users worldwide. WhatsApp comes with roughly 450 million monthly users. The social network's latest reveal is about Linkbench, a new database benchmark for the social graph, which offers free accounts for all open source projects. The courtship between Mark Zuckerberg and Brian Acton, which started through mediator Yahoo 5 years ago, has recently struck a $19 billion deal. They merge.
Strange, Piyush Babu. You speak as if you were born not with a silver spoon, but with electronic devices around you. And what did you say? Linkbench, be it a graph survey benchmark or a graph processing benchmark. And you, Piyush Babu, explain these things to us as one of the Facebook engineers who discusses the development processes behind Linkbench. Why are you so much after its lure? Your fantabulous eye-popping marks in mathematics was a real gift to your parents. Wake up, Piyush, is this our language? Everything textronic, everything coded, encrypted.
No, Jinu. You feel as you were the talker, you will direct us and command us to what you wish? Absolutely no. You are industrious, maybe excellent. We are intelligent. We use smartphones. WhatsApp is the most popular cross-platform instant messaging application meant for smartphones with an incredibly high user base. Before you tweet us moral lessons like our teachers do, let me inform you that with a record processing of over 27 million messages on a daily basis, WhatsApp already has left Twitter behind. And since it makes it super easy to communicate and share files, most people are shifting to it from usual text messaging and other chatting messenger apps. Jago, Mohan, pyare, jago.
Ah, me, a poor man's handicraft, as if I don't know. But do you know, my dear, that every next smartphone user has access to this instant messaging app? Parents and employers are often found worried about the wrong usage of this application among their children. Our parents will also get concerned about the misuse of this application and transfer of unwanted files over the internet.
This makes it really important to undergo WhatsApp tracking to ensure that it isn't being misused. It is good, yaar. Let them crack. We will crack and hack.
What?
No, nothing. Time pass.
Messaging all the time, even at midnight. This troubling habit is killing me. Earlier, it was a text message feature available on all cell phones. But with WhatsApp-like applications, things are entirely different. Moreover, it doesn't require much money, and therefore, communication through such application goes on uninterrupted. But messaging at midnight cannot be accepted at any cost. Firstly, it has a negative impact on our health. And secondly, we might not know to which group we are talking to once we retire to bed.
Yes, I read recently that communication with strangers is how dangerous. People talk to their competitors of their current company. Unethical, but so easy. We teenagers are pretty fast in befriending strangers and equally fast in sharing our views with them. My neighbor's son once shared an obscene file with one of his friends, after which a big fight took place between the two families. Further, do we have freedom of speech? On 28 January 2014, a woman committed suicide due to Facebook abuse and obscene posts. Extortion, blackmail, sex traps, spying, everything is done through these social networking sites. Tweets vacillate between teen vulnerability and outright anger. vitriolic and hate speeches in the name of freedom of speech?
Piyush, please say something.
One thing is for sure. I'm in a talk show in which members belong to Paleolithic era. For the kind of information of all moderates or numbskulls sitting with me, that is a National Suicide Prevention Lifeline. One can report a violation or abuse or harassment at Facebook Help Center. Now, encountering Gino's argument, I say, with an advanced cell phone monitoring application like Spybubble, it gets really very easy to monitor WhatsApp messages and ensure that a child isn't misusing the messenger application. All it requires is downloading the application and a simple installation, after which every single message sent or received gets saved in your password protected web account. And the unique part is that you can read the chat histories even when the user has deleted them from the phone. And since the information comes with time and date stamps, you know when the messages were actually sent and how long did the conversation take place.
Why, Piyush Babu, kaha the tum itne din? Photo na photo, smile karega.
Tu to rahe nahi de Harshal.
Katore pe katora, beta baap se bhi gora. Tu aag laga dega, aag laga dega, aag laga dega.
But dear, Facebook Help Center will simply review it or at the most delete the content. What if it is deleted after it is public? Why not to report it directly to the cybercrime cell and put such people behind the bars? Why to indulge in the soft and virtual world where friends become foes on comings? And your second solution, that was on spying. You mean to say that your parents should spy on you? Contrastingly, you may take some further steps against it. It is they who are sponsoring you and you are trying to lead your parents by taking such giant steps towards your own destruction. Oh Jesus, save me. Save the sweet teen. What kind of India do we want in future?
What is wrong in that? It has many advantages. When you're tracking a phone with WhatsApp spy software, you get to know about all the secret conversation taking place between the target phone users and the others. So, you get to know who the user is communicating with and why, what things are being communicated about, what information is being shared, and what files are they exchanging. This information is dependable enough to know if your friends are really reliable.
A cross-site scripting XX vulnerability has been reported in Hackers News. This could spread malware and rogue applications. Now, we have somehow managed to avoid violent games. Games such as Dead Space 3, GTA, Dead Islands, and many more. Oh my god, so many violent games.
Suno, gaon walo! Ab se GTA, Angry Bird, sab khelna band. Ab jo Ritu ne bola na, wahi khelne ka. GTA to main khelta hu, aur kya bola tha tune?
Just shut up and get lost!
Nahi jaane ka.
Get lost, Harshal! You bring mobiles to school.
Firstly, schools and colleges ban mobile phones because of their connectivity in gang activity and bunking. Technology alone cannot be the part and parcel of a student's life. What could a teacher do if the child remains busy with his or her 24-hour friend?
Hey, chup rahe tu. किसको पता है मैं मोबाइल लाता हूँ कॉलेज में? जिनो देखते को पता है? देविका देखो, देखो, नहीं, क्यों, क्यों, क्यों इतना उबला पानी? चाय से आधा केटली गरम, जा, अब ढिंढोरा पीट दे, देखो नहीं लाना है मत ला, मैं लाऊंगा, अगर मुझे कुछ कॉलेज में हो गया तो मोबाइल मेरे काम आएगा, बोल, तू लेती मेरी जिम्मेदारी?
Get lost, Harshal!
जाता है अपन.
It is disturbing for all of us, Harshal. The new cell phones with cameras can be used to take photos of exam, take pictures in classroom and so on. Attendance can go down overnight and rumors can fly in minutes. Colleges do have phones which can be used during any crisis. Agar hamara accident hota hai, to mobile us ghayal ke kis kaam ka hai? Batao.
Yes, yes, Jinu, you are right. I swear, I will not bring it. Nor I will use it till my board results are declared. I have already wasted a lot of time on this mobile application, commenting for nonsensible things and making new friends. Now, I can't spare time for this. I will have to learn to say mobile, bye to mobile for a year and my so-called friends.
I think you are right. I talk so much about hacking and phishing. It can happen on me also. I just don't want to explain further. I can conclude that we should avoid a fuzzy situation. Thank you, friends. Thank you.
Good dear all. And how can we say that it is our mobiles, our cars or our bikes? Do we have a SIM card to activate or license to drive? Do you have a big question? If something goes wrong, say you enter an objectionable website and download something, or meet with an accident while driving. Just imagine, you will have to run to juvenile courts or be sent behind the bars. So let us try to stop or reduce what is bound to wreak havoc.
Yes, I agree with all of you. I'm a teenager and I send out more than 2000 texts per month, which is an overwhelming amount of information that can lead to problems with sleep and concentration, along with physical stress. We are growing on the concept of connection, not concentration. Let us decide, connection or quality?
Exactly, friends. That's what I said earlier. Text or social media allow us to speak to more people than a normal phone or face-to-face conversation ever would. This may appear like a safety curtain in the virtual world, but we may develop antisocial personality disorder. That is, lack confidence while speaking face to face in the real world. We may remain inferior to the real world. I hope now all of us understand that usage of these things should be controlled. It is our life, and the next generation should learn something good from us, as the oldies gave to us.
That's a good message. So, what are your views on our argument? Please share it with us.
Thank you, dear Neha, and thank you, dear participants, I mean the performers here and the audience there, for sparing some thought and some time to witness this. WhatsApp, Google, Twitter, Yahoo are already a part of our life. Oh yes, Facebook. They are already a part of our lives, and a few more are yet to knock Indian doors within a short while. Say, for example, Whisper, a social networking application which allows a user to post snippets of information anonymously. Others will view it and post comments anonymously. Then there is one more, we call it Ikyak. It is a social networking application which describes itself as bulletin board. You connect with local guys, you get local news. Those who do not wish Ikyak access into their compound will have to go for geofencing. Geofencing blocks the Ikyak access. Most of the schools and colleges in the US and in the UK are using geofencing, as Ikyak has become the greatest irritant in teaching learning process, as it works in a range of 1.5 miles from an area of network. Then there is one more. We call it ask.fm. Once you become a user of ask.fm, others will ask questions from you, and that too anonymously. But you must be very wise and judicious while answering those questions, because after some time, when your answers will be in public domain, you won't have any control either to edit or to delete those answers. That will be very embarrassing for you. Then there is one more. We call it secret. Once a secret user posts a secret, immediately the application sinks down his or her contact list and will find out all the contact numbers, including email addresses, which are secret users. And immediately the message or secret will be forwarded to them. Then there is one more. We call it Snapchat. To exchange photos and videos. The beauty of Snapchat is its spontaneity. Within 10 seconds, the photos will vanish. But the sender must realize that the receiver may save an image by using screenshot or other media devices. Next, now that if you wish to block somebody from your list, from your friends list, go to the menu icon, select the friends list, locate the friends to be blocked, swipe through and the friend is deleted. Oh, on Android phones, long press on the friend's name, edit, delete, and the friend is deleted. So at last, you unfriend, you block, You bring them to semi-friend status. You write some offensive comments against your own friends. And that way, it generates hatred and animosity. Now we talk about computer and internet. Once a crypto locker infiltrates a computer, it holds all the files and folders at ransom with an encryption key. Immediately a ransom note will come, instructing you to pay a huge amount within 48 or 72 hours, or all your files and folders will be deleted as the encryption key will be destroyed. Though we leverage so much of media safety data, also media threat data through the cloud, do you think it is adequate? No, it cannot be. I think cyber sensibility and cyber safety is the only remedy. You need to back up your data, let me say. But how much and where? It is too big. My next question to you, now that most of the political wheeler dealers, eminent personalities are connected with common man through these social networking sites, I ask you one question: why don't they rule us? Why don't they take one step further? Say, one life is equal to one vote. That way, the vastest democracy being chosen by the public and the fairest democracy runs. And in the similar spirit, e-governance be delivered to you at your doorsteps. Oh, why doorsteps? Now through wires into your home. So the most efficient form of governance come to being. Is it possible? Is it possible? No, it cannot be, because by that way we will be creating an irrational mob that will shut our discussion agitatedly and abruptly online. As these are simply loneliness links, not mass links. Every day a new feature is added to these social networking applications. You need to be cyber safe, you need to be cyber alert, as we, as oldies, as Naomi said, oldies, she meant parents, cannot cope up and keep up pace with such changing scenario, or we can say ever changing scenario. You need to be cyber safe, you need to avoid cyber bullying, you must have the courage to block somebody who is irritating you. Let others take permission from you before they tag you, as they don't have any right to spoil your reputation. Don't add any location to photos, videos and instant messages which you send. Most of my girl students are also my Facebook friends. I see their profile information is incomplete, their names are different. I need a lot of time to identify whom I am talking with. When I ask them the reason for that, the reasons are horrendous and dangerous to share with you, my dear kids. In a nutshell, I can say they are victims of cyberbullying. And what do you post in confession pages? Something wrong, something offensive against your own friends, relatives and teachers? Is it the same confession which you make in Mushak Raj ears in Siddhi Vinayak, or in a confession box in a church? No. Then a word was used, oldies, she meant parents. Let me ask you, dear kids, is your social networking similar to our social networking, their social networking? No, it cannot be, because yours is Facebook, theirs is face reality. Yours is in virtual world, theirs is in real world. Yours is of 1,000 or 2,000 acquaintances, theirs is of a handful of solid, concrete friend circle. So there is a huge difference. Now, let me talk about the health effects on you due to these social networking sites. But before I continue, let me tell you, dear kids, I'm using this word you. It is not to individualize the topic. It is to make a general topic more specific. I know all of you do not do this, but most of you do this. And it is all based on my empirical observation upon these social networking sites and the social behaviors that follow. Most of the students who are engaged too much in hyper-social networking and violent video gaming suffer from stomachache, headache, paranoia and antisocial personality disorder. They cannot sleep well. A survey says that an average student who is also a user of these social networking sites cannot concentrate on his or her studies for more than 3 minutes, before or after which they remain engaged in instant messaging or updating their status, or stultifying ennui, boredom. काश कोई लड़की मुझे प्यार करती वगैरह वगैरह. So that way this continues. And then you become a narcissistic fool when you start gauging your personality by the number of likes and the type of comment which you get for your content which you have uploaded. So you develop a virtual personality out of your real personality and you start living in that. Yes, many people say that parents must be cyber alert, they must be cyber literate, or most commonly used term nowadays is they must be cyber wise. They should teach their children which type of comments they should like, which type of content they should upload, vagara vagara. But I ask you, dear kids, how long can your parents spy on you? Every time you have something to hide, you want to move just a step ahead of your parents. Why don't you talk directly to your parents, teachers and friends, especially those friends whom you meet in real world every day? Why do you need to meet them in virtual world again? Why to waste time for these things? These social networking sites were originally meant to connect with your distant relatives and friends at a very faster rate. It doesn't mean you will upload something mundane and sundry and still expect good number of likes or some good comments on those things. Or you can use these social networking sites to connect with resource persons and eminent personalities of your area of interest. By that way, you will be enhancing knowledge fund of the entire country or a state or your own friend circle. Let me tell you, dear kids, there is something called Facebook envy or online envy. When your own friends get more number of likes and more popularity than you, then this generates. Then there is something called Facebook stalking. People may misuse or abuse your profile information and photos and images which you upload. You don't have any control to stop them. This is called Facebook stalking. This is also called fraud. Then there is something called online pressure. When your friend request is rejected, or somebody blocks you, or when you are online and chatting with your friends of different age groups. Now that you maintain language etiquettes when you talk with your peer group, with your uncle, with your elder brother, etc., etc., this generates mental pressure. Most of the career departments have issued warnings against those candidates who fared well in their interviews, but when the online accounts on social behavior were checked, they were horrendous. So I warn you, dear kids, you must be very alert while doing any online activity, because whatever you do off track is going to decide what you are going to do on the track. At last, I must say, self-restraint is very important. You must not use this social networking as a platform to share everything with anyone and anything with everyone. If moderation is good for certain things, then definitely it is applicable upon these social networking sites. In conclusion, I'm thankful to Sri Selson Samuel, PGT English, AEJC, Anushakti Nagar, also my subject coordinator, for composing and presenting such a mellifluous melody in the form of a song which you are going to hear from our students within a short while. I'm thankful to Sri Dhulab and Sri Sachidev for their constant, consistent and uncut video shoot, editing and finishing it to the extent you are enjoying it. I'm thankful to Principal AEJC, Sri Ramachandra Gaur, for allowing us to connect with you. And in the same spirit, we expect you to be on the screen and with a new topic, and we will be watching you as audience. On behalf of all present here, I'm thankful to Dr. J.V. Yakni, Chairman AEES, for allowing us to use this very effective tool, which is ASTER and SIT, and also conveying a very beautiful message that all AEC schools and junior colleges under AEES is one family. We are all family members. ये कल ही की तो बात है यारो, मीलों के थे जो फासले खौफ में, रूबरू है आज के क्लिक और रिमोट में. ये आज ही की तो बात है यारो, जुड़ गए मुल्क और अवाम एक तार में, नेटिजंस की एक नई जमहूरियत है इस जहां में. ये नजर की ही तो बात है यारो, जो पैनी है इल्म की ताकत में, व्हाट्सएप, फेसबुक, ट्विटर और गूगल में. ये यादों की ही तो बात है बच्चों, जो जी है जिंदगी हमने वो भीगे हुए सावन, वो नुक्कड़ की चाट, वो क्रिकेट का मैदान, वो दिवाली के दिए, वो होली के रंग, वो कामयाबी के जश्न, वो नाकामी की तन्हाइयां, ये रौनक की ही तो बात है बच्चों। फिरते हैं अकेले ही लोग निशा के मेलों में, कामयाबी नाकामी जोड़ते नेटवर्क की रेलों में।
एक उछला हुआ पत्थर घर सब हो जाए आकाश में, एक उत्तेजित भीड़ अगर रुक जाए चौराह पर, एक क्रांति जो खो जाए किसी जंगल में, तो स्वर खोखले हो जाए दरिया किनारे, तब मन समझे बस होंगे इशारे। क्या ताना क्या बाना, क्या हंसना क्या गाना, क्या अपने क्या सपने, क्या खोना क्या पाना, कल भोर होने पर हम चलते हैं, देखें कितने सूरज तक निकलते हैं, और कुछ इस अंदाज में हम आपसे अलविदा लेते हैं। गुड बाय फ्रेंड्स, शब आखिर।
Is social networking literally dead? No, I don't think so.
We need to understand privacy statement, terms and conditions, sharing limits and frequency of password states before we react to a content or newsfeed or what we share or upload.
An unprecedented scale of information sharing naturally provides a ground for it.
Do you require your parents to check your internet history to monitor you?
We must know what to write or comment.
News feed that indicate the world is falling apart to get clicks.
Spyware is a nightmare. Show care, beware.
Constant trolling and insulting on instant networking must be stopped. Why shall our opinions be attacked heavily on every comment board?
It's not the fault of the social networking. It's the user who misuses it.
Our lives can't be a rock show.
You get to see more of the things you like. Do you?
We went desperate with antivirus software.
It's not just instant messaging for me now. Only when I have something good and positive to share, I do.
The endless cold bars everywhere. We should not fight with clicks and controlling newsfeed.
If you don't know singer, it may be a pretender.
I am fond of social networking, but neither obsessed nor depressed.
Thanks to it, my mailbox is clean now. All the people who used to send images, messages, greeting cards and all that kind of stuff now post it directly to my social networking site, and that is so easy to ignore.
Yeah, I agree. I phone my friends and ask for their balance.
When you're safe at home, you wish you were having an adventure. And when you're having an adventure, you wish you were safe at home.
Facebook has actually made my life even better.
I deleted it in a week and never looked back. Been about a year, now social networking is free. And I can't say that I miss it.
I feel it as a mere waste of time. Maybe a good pastime.
We must change if it harms the harmony of the social setup.
File sharing and torrents might be free, but there may be a drawbacks that you can't see. Life is too short for sadness, so live, laugh, and interact in the real world.
Updating Windows is a must to leave future problem in the dust.
Now the parents will be conceived on, are you a cyber-wise parent?
Safety is something that happens between your ears, not something you hold in your hands.
One day, YouTube, Facebook, and Twitter will join to U-Tweet Face.
My grandpa says people used to live and interact well before social networking.
Don't take an overdose of these things.
Social networking for me has always been of sharing thoughts and photos with my close relatives and close friends whom I genuinely care about.
Please avoid cyberbullying.
WhatsApp, Facebook, Twitter, is this our life?
So my dear friends, social networking is ironical in its name because it doesn't bring people closer but create big gap in relationship with people who really matters the most in our life, that is, our parents and our family. There are many side effects of saying stuff to social networking websites like Facebook. It can degrade academic performance, medical and psychological complications generate, it is unhealthy to stay up all night long, it is bad manners to not show up in birthdays, funerals, marriages and other social functions, and it is very dangerous to show everyone.